Aloha. Aloha mai kākou e mau aloha. Ame mau kupuna. Aloha. I just want to thank all of you legislators for your hard work. My name is Keli'i Akina. Although I am a state official elected and a trustee in the Office of Hawaiian Affairs, I'm here in my private capacity as president of the Grassroot Institute of Hawaii, from whom you've received a good amount of research and testimony in your respective committees. Although you have my testimony before you today, I really want to share just one major point. We are in a crisis of public confidence in terms of government funding and management of the Honolulu Rail. That crisis has split our community into two polar extremes, those who are for the rail project and those who are against it. You as legislators now have a tremendous opportunity to bridge that gap, because there's something that you can do that our project, AuditTheRail.com, has shown us. Thousands have signed that petition to audit the rail and have contacted us at the Grassroot Institute to let us know that it doesn't matter what side citizens are on, whether they're pro-rail or whether they're anti-rail, they're for greater financial accountability. Now, we've had a discussion of the term audit here today, and I would like to point something out. We've got to be very precise in terms of the call for an audit. The former managing director of the city and county of Honolulu, who is now a HART board member, said audits aren't necessary because it's just mucking around in the past. Our own Mayor Caldwell, on July 20th, spent about 20 minutes discussing the numerous levels of audit, federal, state reviews that have been conducted for the rail. And the point was that an audit will not yield further information. Nothing could be further from the truth. At the Office of Hawaiian Affairs, I am the chairman of the ad hoc committee on auditing OHA, which is something new. Because although we've had numerous audits through the years, in 38 years there has never been a comprehensive search for fraud, waste, and abuse. And that's what I want to encourage you all to take a look at very carefully. There are federal audits, there are compliance audits, there are performance audits, but only a forensic audit that specifically searches out fraud, waste, and abuse will answer questions like why the cost projection for the rail has gone from $2.7 billion to a total of over $10 billion, and numerous questions that you deserve the answers to. It could be that all of this has happened simply because people are good and because they are competent. It could be that we have these unanswered questions because there is no fraud, waste, and abuse. But we have a fiduciary duty as public officials to look at the causes. And so now, let me close with this. Whether you decide to extend funding for the rail from the state or not to extend it, please, this session, call for a full forensic audit to look for fraud, waste, and abuse. Thank you very much for your attention.
Aloha. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Keli'i is here. Keli'i, the notion of a forensic audit, I have been talking to some CPAs, and they said that it's better to use the word efficiency audit. Forensic suggests you're a grand jury, you're coming in, you got something possibly guilty. A efficiency audit is your management and your handling of money. It's more like a discovery that an attorney would do. Do you want to use forensic to scare the people versus an efficiency audit, and are one and the same, except for the implications and the stereotype of one and the other, really any different?
Well, Representative Ward, thank you for your question. Shakespeare put it this way: a rose by any other name would smell as sweet. We're talking about terminology here, so rather than quibble over whether it's called a forensic audit or some other term, it's important to specify the elements. It must be an audit that is independent, comprehensive, and thoroughly looks for fraud, waste, and abuse. This is important because the other types of audit may accidentally discover fraud, waste, and abuse in their attempt to determine performance and so forth. But the kind of audit that this legislative body should call for is one that is independent and comprehensive and specifically searches out fraud, waste, and abuse.
So criminality is necessarily not always associated with it.
Criminality is not the goal for discovery. Facts are the goal. If they result in a criminal application, that's secondary. This body, the legislature, needs to know where the money has been spent, how it's been spent, and whether there's fraud, waste, or abuse.
And you think Mr. Slater would agree with you?
He'll have to respond to himself.
Thank you. Thank you, Keli'i.
Thank you very much, Chair. Any other questions? Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much.